Okay.
JAMSI CDO was birthed out in the year 2008 when April Jade Bonoan Onlos came to Cagayan de Oro to take up law at Xavier University Ateneo de Cagayan. Aside from being a student, she held several Bible studies in the campus. JAMSI first generation was then born, and these are Jared Salvan, Corina Unat, Rhea Malmis, Dame Sambaan, Sasa Iderango, and Niza May Capol. Prayer meetings were held every day at 6 a.m. on the campus grounds of Xavier University. The Lord added the number of the saved people daily. With several Bible studies being held, JAMSI, or Jesus in My Circle back then, had to look for a place outside the campus to continue to hold gatherings as persecutions were starting to grow. The first JAMSI Center was right in front of Xavier University, where JAMSI CDO held its first Sunday service on August 8, 2010. As the church continued to grow, we transferred to another location at Velez Hay Street. Pastor April Jade Bunuan Onlos was officially ordained as pastor of the church by our St. Gentiles Christ Ministries SGCM Senior Pastor on August 4, 2013. In 2014, Pastor April Jade Bunuan Onlos, who was then already a lawyer, married Dr. Pastor Jerry Onlos. Pastor Jerry was ordained as pastor and licensed officiating minister of the church on June 26, 2016. Today, the church is located strategically for accessibility and for the purpose of catering more people at third floor Philinvest building, Velez Street. It also changed its banner and is now known as Jesus and My City Church CDO. Truly, great things start from small beginnings, and with God's faithfulness, JAMSI continues in our thrust of knowing God more and making Him known. Our church history is truly His story, and you are part of it. Let's journey together. You matter.
Thank you.
Our church vision is
to see every transformed life become a committed part of the movement of building Christ-centered, Spirit-empowered, and mission-driven churches in every campus, workplace, community, and nation. God placed in us a desire to see people transformed from darkness to light, from brokenness to wholeness, from impure to pure, directionless to purposeful, depressed to joyful, lost to being found, failure to victor, from being a sinner to being a child of God, through the life-transforming gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. As God has transformed them, we envision to see these individuals become not just a part, but a committed part of what God is doing through the church. By being a committed part, we mean willingness to sacrifice, persevere, serve, and pay the price of time, resources, strength, and even lives to take an active part in God's movement of building Christ-centered, Spirit-empowered, and mission-driven churches, thriving through discipleship in the different campuses, communities, workplaces, cities, and nations.
Good evening, Jamsi CDO! Welcome to Unite. This is our midweek service where we gather together and pray as a church. Before we sing our Thanksgiving song to God, I request everyone to please rise. And please think about three things that you are thankful to God for. What are three things na ginapasalamat ni sa Ginoo karon na week? May it be health, may it be protection, finances, bagong nasakyanan, bagong balay, additional na members sa family, katong mga nanay baby. What are you thankful to God for? As we sing these songs, I pray that we will give to God the praises, the thanksgiving that He deserves. Amen? Amen. Enter His gates with thanksgiving. Enter His courts with a song of praise. Let's worship the Lord tonight.
Heaven over me, flooding over me.
Jesus is the name above all names. When we mention the name of Jesus, every knee will bow down and every tongue shall confess that He is God. For He is greater. His name is bigger. Greater than your sickness. Greater than any illness. Greater than poverty. Greater than any struggle. Jesus' name can move mountains. He is bigger. He is full of power. He is the name above all names, and He is greater above all things. We will praise the name of Jesus in this place tonight. No other name but Jesus alone. Jesus. Jesus, Jesus our Savior, Jesus our Healer, Jesus our Defender, we give you honor, we give you praise, God. Deserve the all the honor, all the glory, all the praise, and the church will say amen and amen.
A blessed day, everyone. For our church announcements and activities, please see the following posters.
In the Old Testament, God repeatedly reminded the Israelites to be honest and faithful in giving back to God what truly belongs to God. And these are the tithes and the offerings. And Jesus reinforced the giving of tithes in the book of Matthew chapter 23, verse 23. Apostle Paul was one of the workers of the kingdom who gladly received the offerings and the tithes and the supports from the church in Philippi. And that's why he said in Philippians chapter 4, verse 18, "At the moment, I have all I need and more. I am generously supplied with the gifts you sent me with Epaphroditus. And they are a sweet-smelling sacrifice that is acceptable and pleasing to God." See? If we are going to be faithful and honest in returning to the Lord what truly belongs to God, and these finances are used for the expansion of His kingdom, this kind of offerings that we give God are acceptable. They are sweet-smelling sacrifice for God, and it pleased the Lord. And Apostle Paul said in verse 19 of Philippians chapter 4, "And this same God who takes care of me will supply all your needs from His glorious riches, and which have been given to us in Christ Jesus our Lord." See, if you are just faithful and honest and returning to God what truly belongs to Him, God will reward us, God will remember us, and He will bless us in accordance to His riches and glory. Now, if you want to give your tithes and offerings, you can do a bank transfer of it through our BPI savings account. And the savings account number is posted on the screen. Or you can send it through GCash, and our GCash account is posted on the screen. Or you can bring your tithes and offering personally to the center. Our full-timers who are on duty or our finance team would gladly receive your tithes and offering, and they will issue you an acknowledgement receipt. Or if it's hard for you to go to the center, you can ask one of our full-time workers to pick up your tithes and offerings from your homes, and they would gladly pray for you and your family. I hope today, as we give our tithes and offering, we have cheerful heart, thankful heart, because our God is faithful. Our God is good to all of us all the time.
Good evening, church. So for the past Wednesdays of Unite, we have been talking about the fruit of the Spirit. And last time, I believe, ang topic na gidiscuss is about patience. Now, we will still be talking about the fruit of the Spirit, and particularly magstorya ta about sa character of kindness. So, sa character of kindness. Now, tonight, the verse that I will be focusing on, or the verses that I will be focusing on, is found in Ephesians chapter 2. Verses 1 to 10, and follow with me as I read these passages. As for you, you were dead in your transgressions and sins, in which you used to live when you followed the ways of this world and of the ruler of the kingdom of the air, the spirit who is now at work in those who are disobedient. All of us also lived among them at one time, gratifying the cravings of our flesh and following its desires and thoughts. Like the rest, we were by nature deserving of wrath. But because of His great love for us, God, who is rich in mercy, made us alive with Christ even when we were dead in transgressions. It is by grace you have been saved. And God raised us up in Christ and seated us with Him in the heavenly realms in Christ Jesus, in order that in the coming ages He might show the incomparable riches of His grace expressed in His kindness to us in Christ Jesus. For it is by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from yourselves. It is the gift of God, not by works, so that no one can boast. For we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do. So we will be talking about kindness, but before we delve in to what kindness is and its relation to God's character of kindness and how we should show kindness towards others, let's first define compassion, specifically what compassion is in accordance with the Old Testament. So compassion, and the word womb is related with each other. In the Hebrew, for compassionate, the word used is rahum. For compassion, rahamim. And these two words are related to the word used to describe the womb, which is rechem. Now, rechem speaks about, or these Hebrew words speak about the tender love of a mother towards her infant. So the tender love of a mother towards an infant. Diba kung ang isa ka mama, sa iyahang anak, ang gugma niya para sa iyang anak is tender, compassionate. And you can even say that when we show kindness, somehow it's related or even the same as the kindness that a mother shows towards her child. To show kindness or to show compassion, I mean, can also be translated with the English words to be deeply moved. So it's still the same word that's used in Hebrew, but it is applied to specify to be deeply moved. In the time of Solomon, when there were two women disputing about the child na kung kinsa ang tinuod na iyahang mama, the Bible says that Solomon was deeply moved by the mother's love towards sa iyahang anak, and moto ang kanang pasabot sa compassion. However, there is a little slight difference between kindness and compassion. And yes, we somehow talk about these two things in the Bible, sometimes interchangeably or together, but kindness is a little bit above compassion. When we talk about compassion, there is a condition why we are compassionate towards someone. Example, we show compassion because there is someone whom we pity. If naitao sa street, na makita nato kalisod, genuinely, wajud sila'y kwarta, walay makaon, and gabeg sila, kagwa na sila'y lain madaganan, you feel compassion towards them. And that's the reason why. When your friend, someone you love, someone you're close to, or a member of your family is going through tough times or going through trouble, you feel compassion towards them and that moves you to help. So somehow compassion is an emotional response to the things that trigger our compassion. But kindness is different, and kindness can be given and applied even if you do not feel emotionally inclined to help someone. Compassion is easy to give to those that you are close to those that you can maybe somehow a bit pity kung naa sila'y kalisod and gusto kong mutabang sa ila. Pero lisod magpakita o compassion towards an enemy or a person that has hurt you. Di ba, lisod? How can you feel compassion for someone nga gidaot ka, has done evil against you, has kanang done bad things towards you and your family? Lisod, may mo compassionate. In fact, kung naay maagian nga kalisod na tao, dili compassion mo ma-feel. Usay mo yung kada, muna, gaba ay tungod daotan or evil ang ginabuhat. Usay inana ang atong thinking, no human as we are. But kindness is different. You can still be kind even towards your enemy. That is why in the verse that we read, kindness is actually correlated with grace. In fact, if we go back and look at the verse, it says that the grace of God is shown in His kindness through Jesus Christ. So grace and kindness somehow go hand in hand. And you can show kindness even when you don't feel like it. Because kindness is somehow equivalent and related to grace. Although we can say that we show kindness when we have compassion for others, kindness goes beyond compassion. Kindness is related to grace, while compassion is sometimes shown because a person has won your favor or because you have become favorable towards them for a reason. Kindness, much like grace, can be given even when the person has not won your favor. You can show kindness whether a person is deserving of it or not. Inana ang kindness. The Bible says that God's kindness is seen in Jesus and His sacrifice. And the sacrifice of Christ in the Bible was not determined by our goodness, was not determined by what we have done. It was not out of pity, but however, it was out of love, and in fact, it was out of God's grace, a favor that He gave. Again, not because of out of pity, not because of what we have done, a favor He gave because that is who God is. He is gracious even towards His enemies. And in the Bible, we are enemies of God because of our unrighteous living. Yet, He showed us His kindness. So, what we're gonna do tonight is we will answer the question, what is the result of God's kindness in our life through Christ? First, from death, we were given life. So this is the first point. From death, we were given life. And it says in verse 1 to 5, look at the highlighted words. You were dead in your transgressions and sins, but because of His great love for us, God, who is rich in mercy, made us alive with Christ, even when we were dead in transgressions. So, una, We are dead because of our transgressions. We are spiritually dead, even though physically we are alive. And the Bible talks about different types of death. First of all, ang pinaka immediate na result sa sin is that man now will die because of the sin of Adam and Eve. So katong nakasala si Adam ug Eve, sin entered the world, and also death entered the world along with it. However, in the same way po, kita as human beings, we inherited the fallen nature of Adam because of his original sin, and karon fallen ating nature, and in the same way we are spiritually dead. While we are alive physically, and our soul, yes, we are alive, but our spirit is spiritually dead. And at the same time, another type of death, aside sa physical death, na atong ma-experience, is that when we die physically and face God on judgment, God, when He judges us, will send us to hell, which is eternal death. So, while we are still living, we are spiritually dead, we are subject to physical death, and lastly, we are subject to eternal death because of our sin. Inana kagrabe ang result sa sala na nabuhat ni Adam and Eve, and it is also the result of us, of our actions and our sinfulness. Yes, our nature is fallen, but at the same time po, we are responsible for the sins that we commit. Di man ka moingon, di ba, nga kanang akatong nga sala, wala man to gituyo. Ang atong mga sala na ginabuhat, we know that it is wrong, but we also commit it anyway. We are slaves to sin, we are struggling with sin, we cannot overcome sin on our own. And we are spiritually dead because of sin. Something in us, we feel that there is something wrong. There is something wrong within us na dili na to masabtan. Some people say that it is the vacuum in our heart that only God can fill. But I say that it is that deadness in our life that only the Holy Spirit can make alive. Only when we have a relationship with Christ can we be brought to life. And while we are still dead spiritually, we try to find ways to somehow bring ourselves to life. People try to seek things that seem exciting. Diba usahay yung mga tao kay kanang makita sila pamaagi to feel alive. They feel as if they are dead. Some people, because of sin, are in depression and are heading towards that cliff of death. Para sa ilaha kay murag feel nila dead na sila daan, then may pa i-end na lang nila ilang life because of the feeling of deadness. People try to cover that feeling with alcohol, with pleasure, with money, with fame, with sex and lustfulness, and anything they can get their hands on in the world para lang matabunan ang feeling of deadness caused by sin. But the more they seek after the things of the world, the more they fall into sin, the more they fall into darkness and death. We are subject to death because of our sins. And you ask yourself, how can we find a way out? Where is the way? Paunsa man na maluwas ko? Paunsa nga na ako'y kinabuhi? We read it in the scripture. It is because of God's love. It is because of His mercy or His grace shown in what? In Christ's kindness. It was the kindness of Jesus that gave Him that motivation to give us life. Because He saw that we were helpless, and without Him, we can do nothing about our circumstance. And it says in Titus 3:4-6, but when the kindness and love of God our Savior toward man appeared,
What did it say? When the kindness and love of God appeared toward man. No? The God whom we love is the God who is our Savior. In His kindness, He gave us mercy. Not by works of righteousness which we have done. No, dili na to mo win ang favor ni God by good works. It's not because of good works or anything we can do that God gives us favor. But according to what? His mercy. He saved us through the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Spirit, whom He poured out on us abundantly through Jesus Christ our Savior. Now, i-highlight na ko ang words dira na kindness and abundantly. Abundant, why? That's because in God's great kindness, wala lang na gihatagan ta niya gamay o kanang okay, luwason ta mo gamay or kanang luwason na ta mo, dira rataman, hatagan ta mo o kanang chance na maluwas, na ma-save. And that is all. Dili lang kana. In fact, the Bible says that God poured out to us a great spiritual blessing and ato pa nang ma-discuss ug ayo sa third point, which is the inheritance that God has given us equal to that of being heirs, equal to the inheritance of Jesus. But here, now atong makita, God abundantly poured out His love for us in His kindness. Now, nga naman, because in that great kindness of God, Jesus, ang darling of heaven, gave Himself over to suffering and death. Jesus, who is God, came here on earth to become a mortal man. Not losing His essence as God. He is 100% man, 100% God. Yet, He gave His life, sacrificed Himself, suffered and died. He gave Himself out of kindness so that He may give us life. He suffered and died that we may have life. That is the kindness that God showed us. And I will say that, oo, pwede ta makapakita og kindness to other people by giving them food. Example, kung kanang naay mga, di ba, beggar sa streets, nagapangayo og kanang kwarta or pagkaon, pwede ta makahatag og pagkaon. And I advise pagkaon atong ihatag kaysa sa kwarta. Pwede ta makahatag pagkaon para matabangan sila, na at least maibsan ang kagutom. Pwede ta makahatag og trabaho if, example, owner ka sa company and nakay nakitaan nga kailangan kay tabang and ga-struggle sila with poverty. Pwede ka makahatag og work. Pwede ka makatabang sa ila physically, makaprovide for them. And yes, that those are good acts of kindness. However, as a Christian, the greatest act of kindness you can ever give anyone, you can ever show to a person, is to share to them the gift of everlasting life. And the gift of life, life while they are still living, and eternal life even after this life that is found in Jesus Christ, through whom God's kindness is completely showered on us. Kanang kwarta na imong ihatag, mawala ra na. Kanang trabaho na ilang makuha, mawala ra na. All things in this world will end and disappear. But if a person has Christ, they have eternal security that no one can take. They have an abundant life. Iyon sa Bible that in Jesus there is an abundant life. Dili ka tong life na dili ka magkasakit or madato sila dili. Some people misunderstand that if they have Jesus, di na sila mapobre, hindi sila magkasakit, di na tinuod. Maski na sa imo si Christ, you can still go through poverty, financial crisis, you can still get sick. Because the blessing of Jesus Christ goes beyond the worldly things in the world. Yes, He will bless us and provide for our needs, pero beyond pa na ang ginatag sa Ginoo. God gives joy that in spite of the sorrow and the hardships in life, dili mawala yung joy. God gives contentment in spite of your lack and in spite of not having any material thing. Nakaagi si Paul og kapubre, nakaagi si Paul og kanang wala siya masanina na masuot, nakaagi siya persecution and hardship, yet because he had Christ, for him, he had everything. And in Jesus, there is life. And Jesus has given that kindness. And when we share the gospel of Jesus to those who don't know Him and have no relationship with Him, we show the greatest amount of kindness. And that is what God wants us to do.
Second, from being sinners, we became God's handiwork. So from being sinners, we became God's handiwork. So let me read this verse. It says in verse 1 to 3 and verse 10, "As for you, you were dead in transgressions and sins, in which you used to live when you followed the ways of this world and of the ruler of the kingdom of the air. All of us lived among them at one time, gratifying what? The cravings of our flesh and following its desires and thoughts. Like the rest, we were by nature deserving of wrath." And then in verse 10, it says, "For we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do." In this verse, we realize, and in the Bible, it says that before we knew Christ, our natural tendencies as human beings, our human nature, was that we were inclined to sin. There are, if I remember correctly, three things that lead us to sin: the world, our flesh, which is our fallen nature, and Satan. The world is full of temptation and sinful things, and it entices us to sin. Satan also entices us to sin. He tries to control us and sets dominion over us by leading us to temptation and controlling us through sin. But in the same way, ang atong flesh, ang atong nature is inclined to sinfulness. And we desire things that we know contradict the things that God tells us to do. God tells us to be righteous, yet we stray from the path of righteousness. And we desire to gratify the desires of the flesh because they are more pleasurable than the things of God. For a person that has not been regenerated by God, to a person that is not yet born again in Christ, to them, righteousness is something that they want to cast away. Para sa ilaha, mas gusto nila na mag-party. Mas gusto nila na mo-indulge sa lustful na things. Mas gusto nila ang pleasure sa kalibutan. Gusto nila ang greed na ma-offer sa kwarta, a temptation of greed and riches. So, our flesh is inclined to evil. We are inclined to destruction, and we either hurt others or hurt ourselves. We desire violence, and we tend to hate. We tend to hurt one another. We tend to sin. Inana ta inclined, because our flesh is that way. And what God did and accomplished by His kindness in Christ is that what He did is take our sinful hearts and change it into hearts desiring and loving His laws and His holiness. When a person puts their faith and trust in Jesus, there is a miracle that takes place in their life and in their hearts. Yes, we have a fallen nature. And in order to change that nature, God needs to create a new person within us and to cast out the old self. And that is why the Bible says that when a person is saved by grace because of Jesus Christ, a person is born again. And in the Bible, it says that a person who is saved is created anew. It is equal to creating a new being. So a person that is saved by Christ, kay bag-o na gyud, in a sense, na bag-o yung kinabuhi, bag-o siya internally, his very essence is transformed by God. And that is why it is comparable to creating something new or to that of being born again as if you were born as an infant. Di ba, a baby? Bago na anak, bago nga life, bago nga creation. Inana po ta, when we receive Christ as our Lord and Savior, we are born again, we have a new life, our heart of flesh turns into our heart of stone, rather, turns into a heart of flesh, and the heart that hates God's laws and rejects Him becomes a heart that loves Him, desires Him, and desires His holiness. And inana ang mahimo na change sa atong kinabuhi. Sa una, ginareject nato si God, enemy nato si God, karon love nato si God, ginadesire nato si God. And yes, dili pa ta perfect because we still have this flesh. There will come a time where God will even change our very flesh and give us new bodies, glorified bodies that will also be in tune with the change that He is created within us. Although wala, di pa na mahitabo karon, it only will happen when Jesus Christ comes again. But karon palandaan, nagakontradict ang atong internal na change, ang atong new person sa kalibutan o sa atong flesh. So we hate sin, we desire holiness, and we love God. And that is accomplished by Jesus on the cross. When we receive Him, we become what? His handiwork for good works. Muna dayo na, nga kita, we do good works not out of selfish reasons. Sa una, we say that we do good works because we want to be acknowledged. It's for ourselves. Although, yes, ginabuhat na to para sa ubang tao, but maybe it's that desire for self-gratification. But now it's different. We do good works because we want to please God, because we love others, because we love God, and we want to glorify Him. And mo na ginaingon ni God, we are God's handiwork created in Christ Jesus to do good works. And because of the change that God created in our life and in our heart, the kindness that He showed in us, we can also show to other people. We are now capable of the same kindness that Jesus showed. Makaya ta na makashow kindness sa ibang tao. And what is very important and first and foremost for us to do as believers in applying kindness in our life is for us to show kindness to our fellow believers in Christ. In the same way that Jesus told His disciples that the world will know that we are His disciples if we love one another, it is also the same that if we are kind to one another, the world will know that we are Christ's disciples. Ephesians 4:32 says, "Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ, God forgave you." Jesus calls us to be kind to one another and compassionate. So, ang kindness and compassionate, there are times that they go hand in hand. And another act of kindness we can show our fellow believers is forgiveness. When we are in the body of Christ, now again, we are not perfect. We make mistakes. There are times that we can hurt our fellow believers. But what's important is what we decide to do after a conflict with our fellow believers. Magdumot ba ta sa ilaha? Dayon katong mga nakasala sa tua, we will treat them coldly or cruelly? Or will we choose to show compassion and forgiveness towards them? Natay tendency na magdumot and maulit. Dayon, may ngunan dayon ta na, adin ako makipag-friend ani niya, Christian, pero kaniyang nabuhat against ako or against the church or against sa person na kaila ko. But we must understand that we are sinners and katong tao na nakasala, ikaw po na kay tendency to sin against others as well. We are in the process of being molded by God. He is shaping us, developing us, sanctifying us to be more like Christ. And we can be more like Christ if we show forgiveness and if we show kindness, yes, to other believers, even when they have made mistakes. And we should show kindness even more if our brother or sister in Christ is repentant of the sin that they have done. We should show kindness to one another. The church is the place where we can practice that. And as we practice it, dira po dayon nga ma-apply na dayon nato siya gawas sa simbahan and in the world. God encourages us to clothe ourselves with kindness. Colossians 3:12 says, "Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience." Clothe. Diba kung magsuot kang clothing, makitaan. Mabalaan po kung wala kay sanina. Siyempre, maklaro man gihapon. In the same way, kindness should be seen in our life. It should be seen by our workmates, our families, our friends. Yes, even the people na dili inahan sa tuwa, dapat makitaan and ma-experience nila ang kindness that is existing within us because of Christ. Muna, clothe imong dadun, imong suuton. Masin asa ka mo padulong, always be kind. And if wala pa na-develop og ayo ang kindness nimo, naa naman na siya dira sa atua. No? We are encouraged that we can show kindness even though it may be our weakness because it is a fruit of the Holy Spirit. If you are saved by Christ, naa ang Holy Spirit sa imuha. Therefore, you can be kind. It can be developed and improved kay naa na siya daan. We can develop kindness and show it to others because we have been shown the kindness of God in Christ and what? We have the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit has the fruit of kindness along with Him. And therefore, we can be kind to one another as Christians and to those outside of our spiritual family. Clothe yourself with kindness. Be kind to one another. Be kind to others.
Lastly, from being under Satan's rule, we were raised up with Christ. So what has God's kindness did for us or has done for us in Christ Jesus? From being under Satan's rule, we were raised up with Christ. Verse 1 to 2 and verse 6 says, "In which you used to live when you followed the ways of this world and of the ruler of the kingdom of the air." That ruler of the kingdom of the air is Satan. And before, again, we were dead in our transgressions, living in the world, we followed the ways of the world, which is a sinful living, and we followed the ways of Satan. When we follow sin and the temptation of Satan, we are following Satan as well. But it also says in verse 6, "And God raised us up with Christ and seated us with Him in the heavenly realms in Christ Jesus." Now, a certain preacher said that when a person is born here on earth, so ganina sa first, second point, akong gi-discuss no, that our nature is fallen and we have a tendency to lean towards sinful living and sinful behaviors. And this preacher compared that to a river. So naisuba, when we say that a river flows down, di ba dili man nato kayang mo-go up against sa current sa isa kasuba kung ga-flow na siya? Nako isa ka-amigo sa una sa high school, habang ga-retreat ni salom sa suba, unya gi-try niya o counter ang flow sa water. Nakraman siya, unya hapit siya na lumos. May galit kayo wala. But na-realize niya na dili niya kaya ikontra ang suba sa iyang kugalingon. Unless naa siya'y sakyanan, naa siya'y boat na naay enough power to go against the current of the river. In the same way, we have fallen into the river of sin and temptation into this life and into this world. And Satan has us in shackles because of sin. We are under darkness, the Bible says. We are under the dominion of Satan. And Satan can even claim us as his spiritual children. Ginaklaim koinotania as His, because we are doing what pleases Him. God says in the Bible that those that obey Him are His children. Those that obey Him are His people. But before we had Christ, we could not obey God. We could not follow Him wholeheartedly and faithfully. We are under the curse of sin, under the dominion of Satan, under darkness, under the chain and slavery of sin, and we cannot get out on our own. If we try to do so, it is as if gasalom ta again sa river nga ga-flow again sa atua. Hindi na to kayanan sa tong kagalingan. That is why God in His kindness sent Christ and saved us. And what He did is that He freed us from the shackles of sin and the shackles of Satan. We are no longer slaves to sin, but instead, we belong to the kingdom of light, the kingdom of Jesus. Colossians 1:13 says, "For He has rescued us from the dominion of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of the Son He loves." In the dominion of Satan, we were slaves to sin. In the kingdom of Christ, we are slaves to righteousness. No, pasabot ana ni Paul, na di siya negative, although when we say slavery, slaves, murag lain man. But being a slave to righteousness means that we love to do that which pleases God, mas gusto ta mo buhat og righteous things, and we can do righteous things. We are uncomfortable when we sin, even if it's just lying. No, dili na to makaya og stomach na makasala ta. And we would go to God in repentance directly og diretso na tungod kay there's something wrong when we commit sin against God. That is because we have been changed by God and we no longer are under the dominion of Satan. Sa una ginagunitan ta niya, karon wala na. In Revelations, ginaingon dadton si Satan, gina-accuse niya ang mga believers day and night. However, no matter how much Satan accuses us, he will never be able to claim us back again because Jesus has saved us and now we are His. No one can snatch us from the hands of Christ. We belong to God's kingdom. Now, what's amazing about what Jesus did on the cross for us is that He did not only save us from sin. Wa lang sad ta niya nagidala sa iyang kingdom. In fact, kung moingon ta nga, kung gisave ko ni Christ and gibutang ko niya sa iyang kingdom, kontento na kayo ko na servant ko niya. Kay, unsa po man akong pangayoon? Jesus is kind, merciful, loving, and good. I will serve Him and I'll be His servant for eternity kung inana. But what the Bible says is that God did not just make us His servant. Although we serve Him while we are here on earth, we are His priests, we are His servants, we follow Him, we follow Him in faithfulness and we obey Him and submit to Him. But we are also His children. In fact, when God fulfills all His promises in eternity, when He comes back, when Jesus comes back, He will give us the inheritance that He has promised. In Galatians 4:5-7, it says, "To redeem those who are under the law, that is us, under the law, under sin, so that we might receive adoption as sons, and because you are sons," nakuha to ninyo, we were not just taken into the kingdom of light and the kingdom of God, we were made into His sons and daughters, His children. And because you are sons, ingon niya, God has set the Spirit of His Son into our hearts, crying, "Abba, Father." We can claim God as our Father now. Satan has no business of claiming us His children. We are now the children of the living God. We belong to God. No one can take us from His hand. We are intimate with Him. And He loves us just as we love Him, because we are known by Him. Og ingon pod niya diri, "So you are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son," unsa ang ingon, "then an heir through God." An heir, a son. Kung unsa ang privilege ni Christ, ma-enjoy nimo. Kung unsa ang inheritance ni Christ, mahatag sa imo. people all sometimes think of adoption as a negative thing. Agi adopt ra ka, ampun ka lang, di ba? Kasi sa mga movies na itong makita sa Filipino, nga ampun ka lang. So, murag lain yung negative kung dunggo na to. Pero kung tanaw na to ang context sa Roman citizenship, dira sa Rome, if a Roman citizen decided to adopt his slave, kung unsa ang privilege sa iyahang anak na gina-enjoy, katung iyang gi-adopt na slave, bahalag slave siya sa una. Tanan privilege, tanan inheritance, if ang inheritance sa anak na tinuod kay kwarta, riches, yuta, balay, tungaon na niya with the previous slave na gi-adopt. Kay equal ang iyahang rights sa real, legitimate son and the adopted son. Muna ang adoption na nasa ato kang God. We have been given so much. Grabe ang kindness ni God. It's so great and amazing. He gave us an inheritance, an eternal inheritance. He gave us heaven, and the Bible says that we will rule with Christ. In fact, there are so many eternal promises of God that yes, they might not yet have been fulfilled, but we look forward to those things because we have an eternal inheritance as heirs to God. He did not only save us from sin, but He made us heirs to His kingdom. Not just citizens, but heirs. How great is the kindness of God that He did not only bring us to the kingdom of Jesus, He also elevated our status and made us His children. We are no longer slaves. Because of God's kindness, we are free from sin. We are free from Satan's dominion. We are free to be with God, and we are free to rule with Jesus in eternity. As a point to ponder and as a conclusion, how great is the kindness of God that He gave life to the dead. We are no longer dead in sin. We have an abundant life filled with joy and contentment. He made sinners into His handiwork for good works. If before we struggle to overcome sin, now we can overcome sin, do good works, and be kind to our fellow Christians and to the people around us. And lastly, He adopted slaves in His kingdom as His children. How great is the kindness of God, and how much more also, if we have been shown His kindness, so should we show kindness to other people by clothing ourselves with kindness and especially sharing the gospel and telling the word the kindness of Jesus, our Lord, our Savior, and our King. So what is your breakthrough word? Please do send your answers to your mentors for accountability. And now let us proceed sa atuang prayer. And on the screen, we have our prayer points. So pray with me as we come to God in prayer. Lord God, akong gina-lift up sa imuha, sila Pastora Jade and Pastor Jerry as our leaders. God, we pray na You will be the one to sustain and strengthen them. God, ilayo sila from any kind of sickness, especially from COVID-19. I pray, God, that as they are doing their best to balance their work and their pastoral ministry, Ikaw ang mutabang sa ilaha, God, to excel in the every area sa ilahang life. And that, Lord, dili sila mahago or burnt out, but that, God, You would give them strength, and as You have said on Your word, in Your word, that they would rise up on wings like eagles as they wait for You. Give them strength, renewed strength every day. Give them endurance. And I pray sa ilaha pag leads a church, may You give them wisdom on how to lead their people, to lead the leaders, to lead the members of the church. God, I pray that kung unsa ang vision para sa simbahan, imo silang tabangan to see where You want us to go. And I pray that as they listen to You, You would be the one to direct them, to inspire them, to uplift them, and to encourage them as they push forward for Your goals. We pray that the leaders of the ministries
the leaders of the discipleship groups. God, we will work hand in hand together with our pastors, and that, God, we will encourage one another, strengthen one another, pray for each other. I pray that not a single one of us will lose hope or will be burnt out, but our strength will be renewed every day, and we will serve you with passion and inspiration and the desire to bring people to the feet of Jesus so that many will know you. I pray na gamiton mi nimo as instruments to disciple your people, to bring people into your kingdom, to develop more leaders, and to create and strengthen the passion of those around us. May we be passionate for Christ, and may that passion come from the Holy Spirit, not from ourselves. Because, Lord, if we trust ourselves and we rely on ourselves, we can do nothing. But if we trust you, and if our passion comes from you, God, we will be sustained. Strengthen the leaders, empower them, give them wisdom, and I pray na ikaw ang himaya sa among kinabuhi, sa amo ang mga ginabuhat, and sa amo ang goals sa life. Next, let us pray for the members of the church. God, I lift you every member of this church. Lord, napagihapon ang COVID-19, and we ask na ikaw mo protect sa amua from any kind of disease, not just COVID-19, from any kind of sickness, especially kay lahi na ang weather karon and lahi ang environment. Just keep us healthy, Lord. Help us to eat properly. Help us to take care of our bodies. God, as members of the church, help us to submit ourselves in obedience to the pastors, to the leaders, to the disciples. Help us, Lord, to follow them and enable us to be a joy to our mentors. God, use us mightily for your work inside the church and outside of the church. Help us to be active in the ministries. Help us to be active in sharing the gospel. Help us to grow in our spiritual life as we read your word, as we spend quality time with you in prayer, as we love your word, as we draw nourishment from it. Help us to grow spiritually. Help us to focus on you, to look to you, and not to look to the troubles around us. Lord, we know that Jesus Christ's coming is very near. So we pray that we will look into that coming with anticipation and excitement. But I pray that it will not be an excuse to do nothing while we wait. Help us to wait with joyfulness, and help us to do the work you have called us to do as a church. Wherever you send us, wherever we may be, if we stay at our home because of our homework or our work from home, may we continue to still share the gospel, and may we use the instruments available before us to reach out to those that don't know. Give us that passion and desire, the same passion and desire that Jesus had for the souls that did not know him yet. God, help us to show kindness to those around us, to show kindness by sharing the gospel to those that don't know. Lastly, let's pray for our country. Lord, we pray for the protection of the citizens of Philippines from COVID-19. We pray, God, na dili magpanic ang mga tao or mahadlok tungod kay kanang dugay na kayo ang COVID and ka-extend siya, and that, God, katong pag-o nga strain sa virus, we pray na dili maepektuhan ang mga tao atong virus, but that you would protect us, and that you would enable those that are formulating vaccines to formulate effective vaccines na walay side effects, but rather maka-heal yun sa mga tao na naisakit. We pray for your protection for every citizen. We pray that every Filipino citizen would come to Christ, would know you, that God, the name of Jesus, will be exalted in this nation, and people will turn to you, that they will not hold on to their idols, nor hold on to their wealth, nor hold on to the world or their sins, but rather they will cast down everything. They will repent of their sins, and they will put their faith in Jesus Christ for salvation. We pray that the leaders, Lord, of this country will desire to follow and obey you, that they will not do anything that contradicts your law, but that, Lord, they would honor you, they would follow your word, they would live in righteousness, for righteousness will exalt this nation. So I pray, God, that the leaders of this country will be drawn to you, and that you will be the one to save them, to reveal yourself to them. We pray, God, that we will not be a country that casts aside, casts aside your righteousness, nor your laws, but that we may follow and obey what you call us to do. May you turn the hearts of the leaders of this country towards you. May you use the church as a light, a city on a hill that shines the light in a dark world. Help us, God, to stand up for Christ, to never turn away. Lord, help us to live for your glory. In all this, God, we thank you for your message. We thank you for your blessing. To you be the glory, the honor, and the praise. This we ask in Jesus' name. And this we pray. Amen.